Father, we thank you this week for the opportunity to do this show, and thank you for the crew that's here, and thank you, Christi, and I thank you for this time that we get to sow into others' lives. We pray for the people that are watching the show. Lord, thank you for drawing them in. Thank you for speaking the word of life to them. Thank you for helping them grow in Jesus this week and find all they were created to be in Him. In Jesus' name, everybody said,
amen.
We'll be right back. Coffee and Confessions. It's a daily devotional type show. We're glad you're here. This is Pastor Christi, Pastor Paul. We're the lead pastors, Living Word Gilbert, Arizona. We do this 5 days a week. We love to bring you a good word from God's word. And so, but what our viewers love is at the end of the show, we're going to bring you confessions from God's word. We're going to lead you in those based on the teaching over your life. We're going to lead.
That's right.
Yeah. And so it's going to be a great time together. So it's a Motivation Monday, right?
It is a Motivation Monday.
Motivation Monday.
So we have some motivational memes for you to get you going on this amazing work week. Today is the day. I can finally feel it. Today, I will catch that tail.
That looks like our pup. Yeah, get it done. Now, have you ever actually seen a dog catch his tail?
Yes.
That's not very, it's not a pretty season.
No, Goose chases his tail and then he continues to go in a circle.
Or if they catch it, they gnaw on it. And then you're literally hurting yourself. The whole thing is just a debacle. So anyways, I got a quote for you. Guy I like to read some of his stuff from. David Goggins. He said, I don't stop when I'm tired. I stop when I'm done. What's up? You ever get to a Monday and you feel like, when's the weekend? Was there a weekend? You're like, hold on a second. Wait, what? Did that just like, it seemed like we went from Friday into Monday. That's all right. If you're feeling tired and it's a Monday, there's nothing better than God's word. So we're going to give you, we're going to drink some coffee here. We're going to give you a good word from God's word. And today we want to talk to you about the fact that you are an overcomer. Now, if you're new to the show, go ahead and put your name and where you're watching from in the comments. And we shout out everybody that does that on the following Tuesday.
That's right.
On New Family Tuesday. But the word of the day comes from Psalm 91:3.
For he will rescue you from every trap and protect you from deadly diseases. Wow. So we're talking about being an overcomer.
Right.
And what's more than overcoming the traps of the enemy?
Yeah, I think that's one of the most important things that
absolutely
we can do. You know, you can be caught under the weight of so many things in life. And I feel that people are trapped by things like mental strongholds
right. In
this day. Mental health is such a huge issue. When they talk about mental health, they're talking about soul health. It's not a new thing. It's what Jesus talked about back in the day. He talked about how to get free. And when he was talking about getting free, he was talking about being free in your mind.
Right.
And I really think that that's an important thing for us to do. Is to find a way to get, you know, if you're dealing with things like panic attacks or depression or loneliness or fear, maybe there's a stronghold in your life, something like an addiction or habit that you'd like to break that you know, something that's hurting you and hurting others around you. Those things can come in your life and it feels like weight. And many times it feels like you can't get out from under that weight, which reminds me.
Story time.
I was at the gym one time and I decided to bench and I didn't have a spotter that day. And I went just one too many reps. I'm like, you know, I thought I could do it. And so I just go ahead and bring it down. And it was like, and it was like a magnet stuck to my, I mean, it was stuck.
Yeah.
It was literally stuck, trapped. I was trapped under the weight. So I did everything I could. I started calling out to people around me to help me. But guess what? They couldn't help. You know why? Because they all had their AirPods in, they all had their headphones on. No one could hear anything at all. And so I'm like doing what I can. I don't know, what do you do when no one can hear you? And it was as if I was invisible at the same time.
Because people are tunnel visioned.
Yeah, they're tunnel visioned. They're not.
Yeah, yeah.
And so I'm kicking my foot up, trying to like kick people or
flailing around. Yeah.
And it didn't work. So finally I dumped the weight and just got up like, hey, it was no problem. That's what I meant to do. No one did notice that entire time, but it was not fun being stuck under that weight.
No, I think I've told you, I know I've told you this before, but speaking of being trapped, I hate closed, tight spaces like that.
Yeah.
You know, even like if we're ever like laying in bed and one of the kids lays and I'm like under, caught under the covers, like that freaks me out. But we played a game back when there were station wagons, you know, and you would lay the whole backseat down and there'd be that little part where the trunk was and there'd be like a flap. And so we had like, I don't know, 200 kids in the back of the station wagon. I don't know. And the game was to have somebody in that little compartment and then all the kids would sit on it. And
yeah, that sounds like a fun game.
I hated that game.
That's some people's nightmare.
Yeah, no. For real. But you know, when you were talking about being tunnel visioned, that's our life is not about us. And that's really what I saw in that story of you at the gym is, you know, where we've got our headphones in and we're tunnel vision and we're doing our thing in our life and there's people around us that need us.
Yeah.
And so to be self-focused, to be inward focused does such a disservice because there's people literally out there calling for help. They're feeling trapped.
Yes.
They're feeling overwhelmed.
Yes.
And so we need to be mindful and watchful in everything that we do.
That's what it says in Psalm 91:3. It says that God's going to rescue you from every trap. Mm-hmm. And so the idea is that he's going to protect you. He's going to rescue you if you do get caught in something. He's your deliverer. He's going to find a way to get you free. And technically in Christ, we're already free. We are the free that the enemy is trying to convince us that we're trapped.
Absolutely.
And so if you're caught in something like sexual immorality, or you've got some addiction or habit in your life, mm-hmm. or maybe it's just negative thought patterns. It's like, I just can't get out of this. I keep, my life seems like it's not very good. I keep dealing with dark, if you will, thoughts. And God wants you to understand that he promises you to be rescued from that trap. You're not going to have to stay there. You've got to believe in freedom in order to walk in and realize that you're free. But the truth is that you already are free right now in Christ. I experienced this in my own life. I had multiple strongholds. I've always been a person of whatever I give myself to. I'm going to give that the best myself to that thing, the best that I possibly can.
Right.
That included the world and sin. Like, I don't want to be one of those Christians that was like, you know, I didn't want to be one of those sinners that was halfway. And I didn't want to be a Christian that was halfway. Like, when I sinned and I was out in the world, man, I went hard at it. Like, I did the best that I could. And I found out there was nothing for me out there. And right. I was fully trapped. And I did not know how to get free. But the same way that he set us free when we first came to him, at what point does Jesus stop saving you? Mm. I mean, that's something that I think that it's important to understand is that there's always going to be something the Lord needs to deliver you from.
Absolutely. You know, it's what we're looking for deliverance in. But here's the thing, you know, sometimes it reminds me of that story because we are overcomers. We're overcomers in everything. But sometimes we look too hard and we always talk about kind of over-spiritualizing, overthinking things. And really over-spiritualizing is overthinking things.
Yes.
So we overthink things. And as believers, sometimes we're looking for the big and the magnificent and the, you know, that deliverance to just like, you know, I don't know, something swoops out of the sky and kind of rescues us type of thing, you know, or that big check. Not that God can't do any of this.
Yes.
But that's what we're looking for. And God's bringing things to help bring deliverance into our lives, whether a person, whether it's a message or a sermon at church or from a podcast
or this show
or a Coffee and Confessions episode, something like that we're looking or that's being brought to us And we're, you know, that's great and that's really good, but God, I need to be delivered from this.
Absolutely.
And he's literally saying, you are delivered from this. Here's your freedom. You just need to take this and walk in it.
I love that.
And, and it's just looking for God in everything and realizing that he's already with us. He's already before us in everything. And we have already overcome the things that we're going through.
Yeah, I want you to this great words from Pastor Christi, and we're not, this week, all this week, we're going to be talking about this. So if you're looking to experience freedom in every area of your life, it is for freedom that Christ sets you free. So he wants you to actually walk in it, not just hear about it.
Right.
And that freedom isn't a rumor. Mm-hmm, you know, mm-hmm. I heard you could be free. No, he wants you to, if you're free, then you can help others be free. But if you're chained up still, and many times even as believers, you can still have those chains. You can have mental chains. You can have physical chains. You know, on your body as far as sickness or whatever it might be. Mm-hmm. And those traps were never meant by God to stay in your life. The enemy means to kill, steal, and destroy. The first real idea is that you have to be convinced that freedom is yours, mm-hmm. that you already have it in the spirit, and that you're going after it.
Amen.
See, we're telling you that you are an overcomer. We're not asking if you would think about it. You are an overcomer in Christ. See, that's the way that God's wired you. You have the DNA of a champion, Jesus Christ, living on the inside of you. He literally led the overcoming life his whole life. He lived that way. That's who he was. And there was nothing that can bind him. Even when they thought they had him bound by the cross. Think about it. When they thought they had him bound by the cross, it was his ultimate victory. Mm-hmm. And so even in those moments that we see it feels like we're really trapped. Mm-hmm. Even in those moments, we've got to understand that God makes all things work together for good to those who are called according to his purposes. Amen?
Amen.
So buckle up this week. It's going to be a great week of shows. Be in here all 5 days this week and your life will change and you're going to go to new levels if you're in here with us this week. All right, let's do confession. Number one, no trap will keep me caught. I'm free by the power of Christ in my life. Ready?
No trap will keep me caught. I'm free by the power of Christ in my life.
Praise the Lord. I might seem to be trapped right now, but my God has called me to be an overcomer. I am free and free to be all God's created me to be.
Amen.
Let's say it together.
I might seem to be trapped right now, but my God has called me an overcomer. I am free and free to be all that God's created me to be. Amen.
Praise the Lord, man. That was an awesome show. Good stuff, Pastor Christi. Hey, would you share the show up? That's something you could do on your way out. If it blessed you, maybe it'll bless somebody else.
That's right. And remember to subscribe if you're watching us today and you haven't yet become a Coffee and Confession family member. Go ahead and subscribe and become that today.
Amen. We'll see you tomorrow. It's going to be a new Family Tuesday, and we're excited about it all. I'm already in Tuesday. I'm there.